At the north of the Cape Fear River, the Confederacy, in the early days of the war, took control of a spit of land in North Carolina. Fort Fisher keeps Union ships at a distance, allowing blockade runners to smuggle in provisions for the South. The entire survival of the Confederacy is dependent on its massive guns. On January 12, 1865, the Union makes its second all-out assault on the fort. For 2.5 days, the Federal Armada bombards Fort Fisher relentlessly by both sea and land. After the massive bombardment, more than 3,300 infantry and Marines assault the stronghold on two sides.
You will secure the landing zone and eliminate all resistance. I want every one of you to meet me there. Wait as the wall breaches further orders. Forward!
Nothing but chasing by enemy fire. The real assault is coming from the swamp. We go along the main defense wall. Come on!
I'm hit, so it's all up to you. Here's a pack of explosives, just in case. Blow that cannon in placement, or our assault is in jeopardy. Don't let me down, soldier.
Oh!
The assault on the west side of the fort is victorious. After several hours of horrendous hand-to-hand combat, the rebels call it quits, with only a small contingent retreating to Fort Buchanan. It doesn't take long for them to surrender as well. Wilmington, North Carolina is taken within weeks. Once supplies to the Confederacy are cut, the end is in sight for the Confederacy.